Hello, welcome to another Riftwalker Let's Play. Thanks for watching. Hey, I'd just like to apologize. My mic died during this part, so I was commentating on this section, but unfortunately, it's out for this fight and the next one. That was very interesting how this boss fight worked. And the next one was interesting for other reasons. Thanks for watching. And just about here, this is where I was like, oh, this is going to be an interesting fight. Basically, it's like the Royal Rat Vanguard, I believe, in that one enemy in like amongst a bunch of others. I thought I'd take care of these since they're easy enough for attacking them, but they eventually just started showing up too consistently, so I decided to just go for the target. And then I was proved wrong. Oh, this isn't like that fight. It's gonna be a lot more interesting. Just the fact that it was disguised in the first part to really get your guard down, and then just comes at you with this. I really enjoyed this fight. Strategy wasn't that complex. The overall boss wasn't that hard, especially since it was just Bolt. He is a kin. Kin are very weak against Bolt. And so I used that to my advantage. Knowing that the area was going to have a lot of kin in it, I got a lot of the Bolt paper to make my life easier. Of note, they're also very weak to Arcane. Arcane is good against both beasts and kin, but I think overall not useful against neutrals. So, I decided to summon someone after my first fight with this, that would just be a lot easier. And he was on the other side of the fog gate. You can do this on this boss. I've done it myself several times, and he runs up and attacks the boss. It actually damages the boss too, as you'll see in a moment. The hardest time I have with this is a lot of time when you get summoned, people don't really know if it's doing damage or not. They don't understand what's happening. Just like I was right there, and so what ends up happening is they don't get as much damage as they'd like to get through. If you get summoned, it's really hard getting people not to go through the fog gate. So if you do this, do what he did. Just sprint at the boss as quickly as you can and get as much hits as you can before the person walks in through the fog gate. Of note, however, if the boss hasn't been triggered yet, in other words, it's their first time there, you can't damage the boss. I actually got summoned and managed to get through there and attack the boss. It seemed like I was doing damage, but when he finally walked in, the boss was at full health. So if you try to plan this to try to help someone out, if it's their first time, it won't work. So if you're trying to help a friend with this, you're going to have to trigger the boss. Thanks for watching my videos. If you like my videos, like, comment, and subscribe. Hopefully I'll see you in the next video.